And welcome back to The Watch, where we finally get to see our young folks try to become full-fledged members. Are you guys ready for your real big old task?
I'm
a little bit nervous, but let's go.
Yeah, the training wheels come off now. This is where shit gets real. So, it is summer of a year after a long session of training. You don't have anything to do today, but Lucas Hassel approached you all since you are clearly in the same group. You all have stuck together ever since the beginning. And he has a job for you to do. He says, go check the notice board by the front doors. And look at the notice that was recently given.
Where's the front door?
I'm guessing over here.
Yep. So you'll see here that there is a very large notice board. It is huge and has lots of different notes on it. Many are quests that go to anyone who will want to take them up. Most watch members will usually accept a quest as a group. So as you guys do, they usually operate in groups of four. And this is stuff that you've just been hammered into training since the very beginning. You see one that has an envelope with your particular names on it. Who would like to take it for the group?
I suppose this is ours. Let me grab hold of that. And I take it and I open it up.
All right. So, it says that there has been a necklace stolen from Galena, which is the nearby town. You are to go to the town and report to Rudy Busher, who is asking for some help trying to locate this necklace.
Ah, I see. We are to recover a stolen item, it seems.
What sort of item?
A necklace. I'm guessing with fancy jewels or something. It must have some sort of value to it.
Yeah, what sort of significance could a simple necklace have?
Exactly. Yeah, I don't see a point.
Yeah. Also remember that you guys, as the watch, you will take these things on like various missions. Sometimes they'll be super important. Sometimes they won't be important at all. But you take on the missions that you want to. But because you're not keepers yet, you don't really get to decide. So that he's just like, you do this one because you can do it. So he says,
all right, go easy talk to mission.
I mean, we say it's easy, but there could be more connected to this. It doesn't matter. There's a new adventure for us. We should probably head out right away.
Yes.
All right. So whenever you are ready, if there's anyone you want to talk to, now's the time because you're leaving Kendall Hall for a while. But if you're ready to go, choose the person to navigate and you can navigate.
For Theolingas.
Who?
Okay.
I think Agilbert could actually proficiently guide us this time.
I feel it's a small journey. If you don't mind moving at my pace, I'll be.
I see what you mean there, small journey. I'm glad you can make those kind of jokes now, my friend.
For the record, he's not wrong. Galena is about 5 to 6 miles away.
Oh, yeah. Really easy.
That music's way too creepy. I'm trying to find music. Hold on. There we go. That's better.
Nice.
Appropriate adventuring music.
Well, shall we, my friend?
Let us go forth.
As before, go ahead and click the travel button whenever you're ready to go. Also, what time did you speak to Lucas Hassel? Early in the morning, midday?
Nah, I guess it's morning.
Early in the morning.
Yeah, they don't. They're not super strict now that you've done most of the training.
Let's just say morning.
All right, so you're setting out in the morning, and you have an easy trip down the road to Galena. Galena's a nice little bustling village. It's not super huge, but it is, it's certainly a nice little town. You've been here several times. Here's a little image for your benefit. But it's a nice little town. There's quite a few people. You've met a few of them every time you come here for foodstuffs or whatnot, whenever you're running errands. And, yeah, you mostly want to go find this Rudy Busher. As the note said, he is located in the general shop.
You cut out for me.
He's located in the general shop.
All right. Well, I think our task is pretty straightforward. Let's go to the general shop and meet with our person.
His name was Rudy, I believe.
Rudy?
Yes.
Rudy.
All right, so you know where the general shop is by heart. It's like right around the corner. You take a left at that one street and you're right there. It's a small town. It's easy to find. And you see the sign hanging above the doorway that denotes it as a general shop.
Back to my roots. All right, so let's go inside and see what Rudy wants of us.
Yes, I shall peruse the wares as well.
You push through the door, and you're instantly greeted with the smells of, like, plants and spices. It's a very well-kept store, and you instantly see a man with a nice, big old full beard, happy to see you. Hello, how do you do?
Hello,
hey,
sir.
Hey, Rudy.
How do you know my name?
We received
a note about the thievery that happened a while back.
Ah, so you're keepers. Where are your capes?
Yes. So that's an interesting thing you bring up. We're not quite keepers yet.
Ah, keepers in training. I do remember you, though. It's good to see that you're almost done. Well, better you than someone else. All right. He leads you over to the desk, where he shows what seems to be a cardboard box, which has a huge hole in it. It's clear that someone just, like, slammed their weapon or some other object through the box and then took whatever was inside. And he's like, I recently got sold this necklace. It looked beautiful, and I was either going to try to pawn it off to someone else, or if no one wanted to buy it, would give it to my wife. Unfortunately, some vandals seem to have broken in and stolen it.
Now, when did the vandalism occur?
This occurred about 2 days ago.
I see. And can you give us the description of what the necklace looked like?
It was, with a long silver chain and a large blue gem in the middle.
I see. Now, was your shop broken into, or how did they actually get to this item?
They knocked the door off its hinges. I only just repaired it today, and you notice that, like, when you look at the door, it works, and you didn't notice it when you were opening the door, but it's clear that, like, the stone where the hinge is, it was clearly cracked at one point, and he somehow plastered it back on.
Jeez. I see. Was there anything else stolen?
Nope.
Or was it this item in particular?
It was just the necklace, which is strange. We've had vandals before. Usually Jonas Walter of the Firewatch can catch them as they run away, but he did not see them, as far as I know. But you would have to talk to him if he did see anything.
Now, I do have a question, sir. You said you bought this item?
I did buy this item.
Now, where did you buy this from?
Well, we have several people who every once in a while will try to sell their wares. As you know, a general store will try to sell whatever we can get. We can't always make a profit simply on crops and foodstuffs alone. So, I simply thought it would be a nice find. It was not too expensive, only a solid 100 gold.
100 gold?
For a necklace of that caliber. That is worth it.
Did you know the person you bought it from?
Of course not. I see people here all the time.
So, it's obvious that the person knew that there was already a necklace in there. And that they were only going for the necklace.
This is correct.
I mean, that would seem to make sense. But is there anyone else you work with here?
Just my wife. But as I said, Jonas Walter, who serves with the Firewatch, he may know more because he is in charge of security for the town.
All right.
I see. Well, I suppose best action would be to go and meet with this Jonas, then, if you have nothing further to add.
He tells you what he knows about the necklace, but as he's talking, a person comes in. He tells the person to, you know, hold on, you know, I'll get to you in a minute. The man has a nice cloak, but he takes off the hood. He seems to be a youngish man, probably in his 30s. Seems kind of unassuming, but he patiently waits in the corner while he discusses more details about the necklace, various engravings that are upon it, and just seems very not upset that the necklace was stolen, but mostly like he wants justice. He wants the person who took this, he doesn't even necessarily want the necklace, although he wants it back, but he wants the people who did it to get the justice that they're due. And he says, for any other details, contact Jonas Walters, who is probably on the north side of town.
I see.
While Agilbert and Wulfgang were speaking with the man, I feel like Baelar would have looked more closely at the box.
At the box.
See if that there's a hole in it, you said?
Yes.
And you would have just looked closely into it.
All right, go ahead and do an investigation check.
All right.
It's a hole. It looks like a hole that was made with brute force. There's nothing really distinguishing it from anything else. You could have really made that hole with anything. Like, it could have been someone, like, taking an axe to the box. It could have been someone straight up punching the box. It's really hard to tell. It's clear that, like, it's a simple box. It just has a simple lock on it, just a little hatch lock. And the inside, there was nothing else in it except for just, like, some bits of hay. It was strictly for the necklace. It looks like this is probably how it was sold to the guy.
Could you give us maybe a slight detailed description of the actual shop itself, like the interior?
Besides the door with the hinge that has been repaired, it is just a simple shop. There's nothing too fancy about it. There's lots of shelves with various foodstuffs, doodads in the far corner, which is like, you know, various hoes, simple like farming tools. This is a very pastoral town, so most of the stuff that would serve a small town. You can also see there's like a section for like cobbling shoes. It seems to be like his second job. A simple shop. You've been here quite a few times to just buy random things on errands.
Alright.
Quite a kingly gift.
It is a very high purchase. I will be feeling it for a long time, but if it doesn't get sold back, it goes immediately to my wife. Don't tell her that, please.
Well, of course. Then I suppose we should go talk to this person in charge of the town's security. Shall we?
Yep, let's go.
All right. So he said on the north side of town. Is that where you want to go first, or do you want to look around the town?
Since this place is so close, we'd be pretty familiar with it.
Yeah, you come here all the time.
Are there any certain areas we would know that would be more like bad parts of town?
Nope, town's way too small for that. Like you probably see in the picture, it's just an itty-bitty town. Not a whole lot happens here.
Probably like the real-life town I actually live in.
Probably. This is a very chill place to be. The biggest drama that happened lately is like the steer that are on the ranch outside of town, they knocked through a gate and they ran out, so the guy had to go fetch them, and it was a huge ordeal.
Bree, now, with the information that's been given to us, I mean, what do you think? Surely there's something going on more than what we've been told, or something that other obvious conclusions we can come to.
Right. Maybe we should talk with that one guy. What's his name again?
His name is Jonas Walters.
Jonas Walters. Maybe we could talk to him.
All right, let's go meet with him.
So you go to the north side of town, and sure enough, he is right by the like fence line. It's like a simple rock fence line that shows the demarcation of where the town begins. And he is leaning up against that. He looks like he's on the verge of just falling asleep.
Excuse me, sir.
Oh, hello there.
Sorry to bother you, sir. We are inquiring. We were notified of a stolen good, and we're told that you would be the best one to ask further about.
Ah, yes. Are you the ones from the watch?
That is correct, sir.
All right. Not keepers. I understand. What do you need to know?
Well, we were informed by the previous owner of the necklace in question that it was a very expensive gift, and it was stolen from him quite recently, but his shop was quite unassuming, so we're trying to see if you could give us any more information as to if you know anything about the person who made off with it, or anything further.
Indeed. He told me about this, and I remember seeing a band of people come into town that day, but they seemed unassuming to me. They passed through, they wandered around town, they went to the tavern, and I saw them leave that night.
I mean, that seems simple enough. Good enough. I don't see anything, do you?
That was the only thing suspicious that happened that day.
My friends, anything. Do you take anything from that?
To the tavern.
You could go to the tavern. He may know more.
Of course you want to drink.
He said those suspicious people went by the tavern, so of course I want to drink.
I know what you're truly moving there for. You don't have to lie to us anymore.
He wants a rematch. Still kick his ass.
The longer you all chit chat, the more Jonas looks like he's about to take a nap. He's not
this
focused
lazy
anymore.
Let's just go.
You've seen him a few times. He's pretty good at what he does. He knows how to scare off kids when they're being rebellious, and he knows how to handle trouble if it comes. But he's no warrior.
He's really gotten comfortable in his position. I'll tell you that much. I'm done with him. I care not for his lack of instinct or knowledge.
All right, come on, let's take a leave.
Alright,
just
so
doing his job.
You head around the two streets and off to the left, and there's the tavern with its nice doors. You kick open the doors, and everyone just kind of like nods in your direction as you pass through. There's not a whole lot of people.
Is that
here.
Really necessary to kick down the doors?
Hooyah! <again? laughs>
Howdy, says the tavern keep.
Yes, hello, and all those formalities. We're here to do some investigating and, I suppose, drinking.
Investigating, you say? Drinking I can handle. Investigating is not my forte.
I do not ask of this from you. I suppose, who all wants a round?
I'll have one.
Sure.
Hi.
Everyone gets hit up with a round of beers.
Nice.
Time to throw down those constitutions.
Nah, you don't need constitutions.
I want to see how drunk I get. No, I'm kidding.
I mean, you're not just piling it down like last time. You're just having a nice drink.
Right.
But, shall we start talking to some of the people? Is there people with us, or is it just the barkeep?
There are a few people lying around. They're mostly townspeople. You recognize a few of them. You don't know a few others. You would know that the tavern person, the tavern keep, probably knows more than anyone else, because he sees the most people.
So, my friend, have you seen anything unusual as far as newer people in town, suspicious folk, groups of people, if you will?
Oh, yeah. There was those four people who came into town the other day.
Four people, you say? Yes. Description of any sort, my friend?
Well, they had a variety of looks. One was big, one was small. I believe one was an orc? I don't remember. They came into town. They seemed friendly enough. They paid for their drinks. No trouble here.
A friendly orc?
I believe so.
You'd be surprised.
I hope they didn't take all your mutton.
Not this time. I've had trouble
with
the
past. They at least paid for it, right?
They did all pay.
Well, then I suppose that's not up for question, but Were any of them carrying any sort of jewelry?
Well, I didn't see any unusual jewelry. They came in about 3 nights ago, pretty late at night, almost at midnight, and they drank for a few hours and left.
How would you describe their mood? Were they jubilant? Were they sorrowful?
They seemed very contemplative. Perhaps they were traveling all day and simply wanted a place to rest. I don't know where they may have rest, but perhaps they left town that night. They could have been in a hurry.
Had they spoken to you or anybody else in the tavern or in town that you noticed?
No. They, in fact, sat at that table over there, and he points to the corner of the room. There's one table, like, jammed up into the corner.
Hmm, yes, let me go take a quick look. I'd like to go investigate that table in the corner.
Go for it. Give me that investigation roll.
There we go.
It is definitely a table. You see a variety of, like, graffiti dug into it. It's an old table.
Town snakes rule!
Well, I'm certainly glad it's a table.
It's a very nice table.
While
it's
Wolfgang...
an ornate table in the middle of a tavern, yes. I see.
While Wolfgang...
There seems to be nothing strange.
I ask the keep if... While Wolfgang's looking at a table, I ask the keep if he saw any of them leave?
Ah, yes.
For a while?
So,
sitting there?
Come here. And he leads you and whoever wants to follow him to the kitchen.
I'll go.
There's a large window in the kitchen above where they prep the food. And through the window, you can see the north side of town. You can even see Jonas sitting on the wall. Pretty sure he's taking a nap now. He's just leaning against the wall way over there. But you get a clear view across the fields over pretty much as far as the horizon line, as you can see. Just lots of rolling hills. And he says, whenever they left, I felt odd about their disposition. So when they left, I glanced out the window. I saw them head north toward the woods.
Towards the woods? Do you suppose we should investigate there further? Do you have any other details I suppose you can give us? Were they acting out in a certain matter? Or were they staying close together as they left? Or
they seemed to leave as a group. It was quite a while before I saw them head toward the woods.
Very late at night, or...?
Yes, late at night. Probably before 2 a.m. They left about 2 a.m., and I saw them traveling in the moonlight around 3 a.m.
Yeah, that certainly sounds a bit suspicious, but it's our only lead, so I guess we can go look.
As you may know, Jonas Walters is in charge of security. He may know more.
We just came back.
We discussed with that lazy git.
Did you ask him about the people? Did they do something?
He merely directed us to you for further information as to...
To me? I don't know anything about law enforcement, my friend.
Well, I guess we could go rouse the sot. See if we glean some more information from him. What do you folks think?
I think if I have to deal with that dolt any longer, I swear... one of these acid bubbles will go towards him. I should not speak in rage like that. I apologize. Yes, let's ask one more time.
We all speak as we do in the bar.
I say we go to the woods.
Well, I mean, we don't really have much of a lead to go on. Do you think we should get some more information first, Baelar, or...?
I mean, you could certainly split off if you want, my friend, but I would not do this alone if that is your choice.
It is up Baelar? To you.
Fine information.
It is possible that you didn't ask Jonas enough questions.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I suppose we could return and ask
him
something else.
You could also consult other people on the north side of town.
I'll leave this to our fearless leader, I suppose.
Who, me? Hurt.
Yes, that would be you, my friend.
Yes, you.
Oh, well. Blast. Now, there were other people in the tavern to question as well. A few we did not recognize, but a few regulars as well.
Do you want to talk to those people?
If it would behoove us for getting some more information.
Would you like to check as a group, or would you like to just talk to them individually and like kind of spread out and talk to everyone?
I'd prefer just to get their attention as a whole, see if anyone remembers.
All right, so just like ring out in the tavern, just like, hey, see any nerds?
Yes.
All right, go ahead and give a perception and then an investigation roll with advantage.
All right.
Why didn't it do that with advantage? That's weird.
Perception and then investigation?
Yes. And go ahead and roll both one more time, because I don't know why I didn't roll a second time. That was weird.
Yeah, none of these is the roll when.
Yeah, they all have been doing a single roll.
Weird, I hadn't noticed. Oh, shit. Oh, God.
Oh, shit. There we go. Oh,
roll!
So,
Nat 20s.
You called out and you're like, hey guys, and no one paid attention, and they're like, hey guys, and everyone just like completely paid attention, and you ask them about having had seen anyone. One person remembers seeing the same group that the tavern keep mentioned. They were clad all in black and they didn't really talk to anyone. He specifically tried to talk to them, you know, just trying to make friendly conversation, have a beer with them. They didn't want any part of it. And he saw them leave about the same time that he was leaving the tavern. He saw them in town hanging out by, like, one of the statues that have been erected near the town square. But that's when he had to go back home to his wife, and that's the last time he saw them. He does remember it was very near the apothecary and the general store.
Ah.
Well, another lead, another thing to investigate if you...
He also mentioned that Jonas is probably the best person to talk, because Jonas was awake that night.
I honestly don't believe that.
Well, I think that's enough information that we can glean from this tavern tonight, folks. Let's set out to speak to Jonas one final time, then we can move on to whatever.
If we must.
I'll buy you a beer.
Would that really be enough?
I'll buy you two beers.
Okay, I might actually be able to do this.
Let's go.
Alright, so which way are you heading?
Let's head back to speak to Jonas.
Alright, so you do in fact come back to Jonas. He is in fact sleeping.
I cast Thunder Wave.
What the fuck?
Might wanna...
Why?
This is the DM coming in and saying you might not want to do that.
Alright, no, I don't.
I could cast Mage Hand and mess with him a little bit.
You could do that.
Oh, and I'm drunk. I'm gonna do this shit. Listen, friends. I've got this. Let me take care of... Excuse you.
Alright.
Don't interrupt me.
Leave the poor man alone.
He is. He's completely unaware, so do what you want. You have zero restrictions.
Mage Hand, and I push him over to this. You say he's sitting in a chair?
He's sitting on the wall.
He's sitting on the wall. Oh, so my Mage Hand trips him up from his legs.
So he's sitting on that wall. He's just kind of, you know, he fell asleep like right where he's sitting. He's not like leaning over the side. He's just like kind of like along the wall, like lengthwise. So as soon as his legs come up, he flops over on his back. That's when he wakes up. He tries to jump forward to counteract the roll he feels he's on and ends up just flopping over to the side on the back end of the wall.
That's, oh, yes, wait.
He's very out of his wits, but he recognizes everyone, and he doesn't really know that you did that, because he was completely asleep when it happened.
Hello, my friend.
Hello again. Sorry. Hi.
I helped him in. I helped him in getting back up.
Alright, he gets back up.
Sorry about that. Strange weather we're having today. At any rate, wanted to know, yes. we had asked you previously about a band that you had mentioned seeing.
And yes, I remember.
Yes. We forgot to ask. Could you give us any sort of better description as to what they looked like? What we should be on the watch for?
Well, I saw a band of people leaving in all black, and they went north of here. There was a man who just came from the tavern. We talked for a bit before he had to leave. But they passed us by right on the road and went north. They didn't seem very talkative. I tried to say hello to them, seeing how they were doing. They didn't have any torches. They just walked past without a word.
So no mention of where they were actually headed.
No. They came from further in the town, near the apothecary and the general store.
I see.
It was very curious. I watched them head into the forest to the northwest.
All right.
There was no one out at that night, at that hour of the night, so they were the only people crossing the fields.
Well, gentlemen and lady, I believe we have our suspects at least. Thank you, Jonas. I believe if everyone is in accordance, we should head out to the northwest and see if we can track down these darkly clothed bandits.
I told you guys the woods.
But now you know the exact direction.
Exactly.
Yes.
Sure. So northwest is your bearing. Which way do you want to go? There is a road that heads almost northwest, and there are the fields to the north.
I'd say road to the northwest is our best chance. And I believe Jonas had mentioned that they were headed towards the forest, or was that, no, that was the tavern.
Both the tavern and Jonas have mentioned the woods to the northwest.
All right. I say we make a direct beeline to the woods of the northwest.
All right. So follow the woods or across the fields? That's your choice.
Across the fields.
As you choose, roll travel.
No.
You just went straight across the fields. You came to the line of trees. You continue.
All right. Should I roll travel again?
Yes.
Okay.
Very good. So you cross into the woods. It's very similar to the woods that are north of the of Kendall Hall. Just a whole lot of thickets of trees, lots of bushes. Nothing too familiar here. You're probably going to have to travel further north.
And so we do.
And so you do. But, all right, hold on just a minute. Let me see. Interesting. As you're walking along, you see an elk.
Ooh.
Hey, look.
It doesn't seem too startled at you, but it's mostly looking you up.
I cast Speak with Animals on myself.
All right, you're speaking with animals.
This goofy trick again, I swear.
What does that translate to in elk?
Hi.
It nods at you. Please, translation. Google Translate elk.
I simply ask if it had happened to see four black-clothed humanoids pass through earlier in the past few days, or picked up any sort of scent of unsavory folk about.
It nods at you.
I see. I'm gonna spare you the further vocalization. And I simply ask if it could point me in a direction of where it was last in the knowledge of where that was, or where that group was.
It begins walking in the same direction that you were already walking, and it seems to be letting you follow it.
Then I will follow it.
All right, do another travel roll. All right, so you continue following the elk for a little while, and you come to a creek. It doesn't seem to want to cross the creek, but it's, like, standing there, and it's trying to tell you, like, that direction. So further to the north.
All right. Good boy.
Is it gonna take a drink or not?
It doesn't take a drink. It's just kind of like looking to see what you all do.
Well, I wish it would take... I'm thirsty, too.
Wolfgang, are you still drunk?
A tish bit. I'm 19, okay? I'm small and gangly, and alcohol just runs through my system. Leave me alone.
So what do y'all do?
Hmm.
How old are you, Blargh, by the way? Like, you're your character.
Since I'm Ashel, I can be pretty old, so I'd say, like, 30-something.
Yeah, I thought you were the oldest of the group.
I mean, that's not quite true.
Oh, how old are you?
I'm actually 99.
Really?
That's about middle age for halflings.
Oh, that's true! You're halfling. I forgot.
Should I change mine?
Well, no, like, that's actually probably a little too old. If you want to be, like, an elderly halfling, you'll probably be around, like... What's a good age? Probably around your 70s.
Okay, that makes more sense.
But what should you do? The elk is pointing north, and it seems very disinterested. It's probably going to walk away soon.
Let's head north.
You could always speak to it more if you wanted to.
I ask if it has any, I ask if it has any sort of warning against what is towards the north.
Hmm, interesting. Roll a straight d20, please.
Oh.
Damn.
Oh, Jesus.
Wow.
That's not necessarily a nat fail. That's just mostly deciding, like, what it's thinking when you say that. Hmm. And how does it respond is the question. Hmm. Now, how does that translate? It warns that there is a ravine somewhere to the north that it, like, cuts through the trees. And it could disturb your natural path as you hop through the woods.
Hmm.
So, that it's very elk knowledge, and it says so with... Oh! So,
all right.
you may not know how useful that is, because you do not scamper through the woods.
Compatriots, I sense danger ahead. Not any great danger, but possibly an ambush. So it's best if we keep our wits about us. The elk has informed me that there is a...
Maybe you shouldn't have bought me a drink.
Remind me what the elk said.
It was saying there was a ravine to the north in our direct path, so it could change the way we would have to progress.
That's true. So you may now do as you please. The elk is super disinterested. It's ready to go, like, munch on some grass.
I pet its head.
It nods at you. It, like, kind of bumps you with its horns.
Ow.
Not, like, a bad bump. It's just like a love tap.
I'm a bitch. Ow. Let's go forward to the north.
All right. Roll travel. Interesting. All right, it is about evening now. It's about time to start thinking about setting up camp. You are deeper into the woods.
Hmm.
You all remember that the woods in this land of Bohemia are a little bit spooky at times, and people say to stay away from the woods at night.
Blasted right in the middle of them. Well, folks, I think we best make camp soon, if not now.
Okay.
I agree.
You're sober by now. Jesus, calm down.
No, I'm kidding.
So you are we making camp?
I think so. That seems like the best course of action right now.
All right, folks. Choose your watches. Each of you gets one watch, or you can double team like you did before.
I think as more experienced folks, we have a better chance of just keeping watch on our own. What do you think, Brie?
I agree.
Baelor?
Yeah. I'll take third watch.
All right.
And that means your lastness.
Again.
So, everyone, please roll a discovery. Do it in order of watches, please. So ACS first, then I believe it was Beckens, then Blargh, then North.
What are we rolling here?
You're rolling discovery in the bottom left of the screen.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. Ah,
right.
Or, you can... He wanted it in the order, but...
Yeah, okay. It's fine. We're smart enough to figure it out. The night passes uneventfully.
All right.
So you wake up in the morning and you remain in the woods. What do you do?
Well, we don't really have a trail to go off of, but Baelor, is there a way you can try and scout around and see if you can find any sort of tracks we should be looking for?
Now, if you'd like, you could always travel with a skill. If you'd like to, when you travel, also roll your skill that you would travel by. You could do survival, you could do nature, a variety of things. Each of these will give a various benefit depending on what you use. Stuff like survival could help you gain like foodstuffs if you need some. You have plenty of food on your person right now. Nature could help you find better paths. Athletics could make you power through the night without problems. Various stuff like that.
How about stealth?
You could roll stealth if you wanted to.
Is that or intimidation, just powering through these woods like
intimidation?
I'll give
is
no
not
fuck.
There's no use to that.
Alright, fair enough. I think it's best if we keep ourselves alert and roll perception.
Alright, so you can travel with perception. Roll travel and then roll your perception.
Alright. Damn.
You don't see a thing while you travel, but you... Which direction would you like to travel from your camp? Pick one of the cardinal directions or anywhere in between.
Really don't have much to go on.
Yeah, so you're in... you know from where you've traveled, you've left the town to the northwest on a road. You entered the forest at some point on the road, and then you traveled north straight off the road somewhere deeper into the forest. You haven't found the ravine that the elk mentioned, but you did find the creek that the elk stopped at, and that's all you know.
I say we continue to press northward.
So do northward?
Yep.
All right. And as you travel, nothing eventful happens. You have traveled several miles through this big old woods. You think you see a clearing, but it's several miles off to the north.
All right, folks, I need some help. I'm not sure if I'm leading us towards the correct direction we're looking for. Does anyone have any sort of ideas as to what we could do to aid us with our quest of tracking down this band of people?
Well, you know, I do wonder if they've actually left any manner of tracks.
Can maybe always look.
What kind of roll?
Perception or investigation?
Let me see. Let me investigate.
I would also like to look.
Holy God, you fuck it every time! Every time you roll any int check, you're
I'm
just
a
like,
smart
Jesus
cookie.
Christ, every time. I'm just baffled. All right, well.
Sherlock will
Yes.
I will not give you a benefit now because there's nothing at your current location. ACS, choose a direction to travel and we'll see what happens.
All right, let's travel to the northwest.
All right, so you head to the northwest and you do see that the clearing that you thought you saw when you were heading due north is in fact a clearing, but there you're not there yet. You're still in the woods because you're just kind of like going along the tree line, basically. You're not quite out of the woods yet. However, you do see tracks on the ground north. There has been a campsite here, and you see they go somewhere to the southwest from this location.
Friends, I think I noticed something.
What have you spotted?
The footprints on the ground. Looks like there might have been a camp set up here. It could be our people. Where is it heading? Southwest. Yes, southwest.
Yes, going back?
I suppose, but I'm following these tracks. Yes, that's where they lead.
And remember, the Galena, where you came from, is to the southeast.
Hmm. Can you tell how many people were traveling?
Let me see. Hold that thought. In fact, if you would like to continue traveling, unless you have more to talk about while I look shit up, I will tell you in a minute.
No, it's an easy leap. Let's follow this along. This is the first set of tracks we've really come across that were not our own.
Oh God!
Oh Sorry. God! Help! Help!
Sorry.
It's okay. I will say. Hold on. I'm going. Roll perception with advantage, North.
Just a regular roll. Do I do a specific thing?
Perception with advantage.
Yeah, but I mean in the actual character sheet, or do I just roll it as usual?
Oh yeah, just roll it as usual. It should pop up the perception. Perception.
There we go.
How to interpret that. You notice that you think you might have seen someone near you. While you were looking around, you were paying attention to the forest in all directions. And when you saw the tracks, you got really focused on them. While you were looking at the tracks, you looked in the distance and you feel like you saw someone, but you weren't 100% sure.
I feel kind of unnerved.
It's not necessarily like an unnerving feeling. You just feel like that was a human you saw. There was some sort of human nearby.
I still feel a little unnerved.
What is it?
Is there something here? Is there something moving?
What do you see? Where are you seeing this?
He sees it to the south.
Can I look and try to see something?
You can also try to look. If anyone would like to help him, he can gain advantage.
Nah, he's good. He's got it.
Yeah, he sees.
It's my elf eyes.
How do you want to look? Do you want to approach that direction, or do you want to pay attention, like really closely?
Pay attention, because I'm not really sure what he's talking right. about.
Let's see. Let's see how it goes. Oh, yeah. You distinctly see, as you just, like, you kind of tell the whole group, hush, hold on, just give me a minute. You pay attention to the south, and after, like, a solid 5 minutes of just silence, and everyone's just kind of like, why are we shutting up? You see someone pass between a few trees.
Oh, he's right.
It was There's distinctly someone. A person.
You saw it too, Baelar.
Yeah, let's go.
Let's go, absolutely.
Yeah.
If you think so.
Please, Baelar, lead the way, because I have not seen any of this.
Right, so it was southward.
Use your special
it's due southward, southwest. Maybe like 500 meters.
So just travel.
Yeah, don't even have to travel. Go ahead and roll a straight d20.
Alright.
Shit. So you went to the spot where you saw the person, but you don't see them again. Roll an investigation check.
Shit.
They seem to have disappeared, but you saw them go somewhere southwest.
Baelar, are you sure you saw them here?
I'm certain there was someone.
I mean, you have to understand, I saw it too. I don't think we're both going crazy.
Hmm. Well, let's just continue with this trajectory.
Remember, he was only 500 meters away, so that's not very far.
Yeah, if we hurry, we can still catch up to whoever that was.
If y'all want to hurry while you travel, someone travel and then roll an acrobatics? Acrobatics or athletics, either one.
I'll try the acrobatics roll.
Oh, okay.
Or Beckens, you can try that. I think we both have us. Was it with advantage, though?
Here's what we'll do. Who wants to lead?
I don't think I should.
It's okay if you lead.
I mean, I think I saw the person going that direction, so...
So, you can, if Beckon wants to lead, someone can help her, and she can get that 22.
Okay.
Because you have a lot of people looking for this thing that you saw. So, if someone would like to do that, also roll the same check. So, an acrobatics.
Gotcha.
Check. So yeah, you definitely knew where that person was. Like, you didn't see them at first, but once Blargh pointed it out, you knew which way they went. So with your knowledge of where they were and their knowledge of, like, the route southwest they could have taken through these brambles of trees, you instantly start walking in that direction, and soon you see someone walking through the forest.
Shh, everyone. Quiet.
They are cloaked in just a simple cloak. There doesn't seem to be anything unassuming about it. It is not a black cloak.
There's only one person?
There's only one person.
Does anyone wish to talk to them directly? Try and confront them?
How far is that person?
Probably about, let's say, 100 feet. They're like, they've kind of lost their bearings. You can see them kind of looking around.
Bree, you're the fairest of us here. Do you want to try and speak with them?
Sure.
Perhaps we can...
Should I ask them if they've seen any... black clothed people lately?
That's probably a good idea.
Okay. So should I just, like, call out for them?
Yeah, if you want to. That's up to you. You could also sneak up to them. You could try to figure out more about them before you talk to them. Anything.
How would I figure more out?
If you want to analyze them for a minute, what would be a good roll for that? That is a good question.
Perception, maybe?
Insight?
Insight.
Yeah, I like insight. Insight sounds like good roll. So, you see that they've lost their bearings. They don't seem to know what to do.
Okay.
And let's see how they react to that. Oh, man. So, they're clueless. They don't seem to know what they're doing, and they seem very lost. But you know that if you tried to approach them, they would not notice you.
Okay. Would, calling out have them notice me, or...?
Oh, they definitely notice you if you call out. There's no one else in the woods but you guys.
Hey!
He spins around immediately toward you.
So, we're, like, by him now, or...?
You're the same distance because you did not approach him.
Okay,
so you're about
100
feet. Alright, so you're approaching. He seems super nervous now. He's not It seems like he wants to run, but he's not making an action. He's not doing anything.
Is there anything wrong?
he seems very disturbed. He's not answering you. He sees all of you, so anyone can talk.
Right. At this point, I'd like to call out to him and say, hey, nothing to be concerned. We just had a few questions if you have some time. You seem a little bit lost yourself. Perhaps we could help you.
Yeah, sure. He seems less nervous, but he doesn't seem to want to talk to you guys. So he's letting you approach.
Okay. Let's approach cautiously.
Okay.
Yeah, slowly, calmly. So Baelar, no rage, please.
You see Baelar just lowering his arm and
I'm going to
trying
keep
to relax.
My distance.
As you wish.
So what do you say?
All right, excuse me, sir. Sorry to bother you. We just noticed you were in the area. We have been trying to track a group of 4 cloaked people who have made off with some stolen goods, and we were hoping that you might have perhaps some information. You're the only other person we've seen in this area so far today, the past couple days.
How far would you get close to him? Like, at what length? How many feet?
I'm not in his face, but you know, a comfortable distance, so I would say maybe like 15 feet away, perhaps.
15. Everyone make a perception check. Do it with advantage.
North is still back.
Yep.
Does he get advantage?
Everyone gets advantage.
My advantage is 9.
Well.
Why are my advantages not working?
I don't know. That's really weird. Anyway.
I see everything.
Wulfgang and Bree and Baelar, you all see immediately. This is the guy that was in the general store earlier.
Oh.
He kind of bumbles out a reply like, oh yeah, I was just walking through the woods, yeah.
Walking through the woods for what purpose?
I was just taking a stroll, as you do in the woods.
And yet you're getting lost.
I mean, it's a big woods. I mean, you're lost too, it seems.
I mean, no. We found our way. You seem to be headed somewhere.
I didn't really have any object. I was just walking. It was just good exercise.
I would like to roll perception one more time to see if I can glean where this guy's telling the truth.
Roll insight instead.
Insight, okay.
Go ahead and do it with advantage. I want to see.
Okay.
Oh, hey. Yeah. He's super lying. This guy is lying to your face.
This guy's a lying fuck. All right, I'd like to roll intimidation and make it clear that I don't believe what he's saying. And that he should not be one to lie to me.
Roll
or to anyone else
first.
Here. Alright. Well, from your mannerism, I can clearly tell that you're not being truthful with me. I can tell that you are lost, in fact. And that you honestly have no good business being out here.
I don't know. Go ahead and roll your intimidation. Roll it with advantage. He's freaking out.
Yeah.
Oh right. Yeah. Oh man, you freaked him out. Okay. I'll tell you the truth. Okay. I saw you all here in the store back in Galena. I heard about your quest to find this missing necklace, and I wanted to follow you. That necklace interested me. I saw it yesterday, and I only recently heard that it was gone. And I don't know what to do. I thought following you by yesterday, I mean before it was stolen. And he's like, I really wanted that necklace. So I thought maybe following you would lead me to it.
And what would you need with such a necklace?
Well, you see,
are you going to pawn it off yourself?
Yeah, not. I mean, by pawn, I would purchase it. I have plenty of gold to
please
buy it for myself.
Spare me.
It's true. I see you are a magical user, as is myself. I see great value in that necklace. That's why I wish to follow you. You seem to know where you were going.
And yet, we were tracking you.
Tracking me? For what purpose?
We saw you shuffling about in the shadows. Actually, more towards the direction we were heading.
Okay. What are you planning? I'll be honest. I was following you the entire time. I've been following you since you left the store.
I don't care for this.
But why did you... Why were you going the other way then?
I got lost. You traipsed across the verge of trees and I didn't see where you went. I got confused.
This man is useless to us.
You can always make an insight check to see if he's lying. You all can do it. Oh, yeah.
Oh, shit.
Wolfgang doesn't know shit. But you see immediately, Agilbert, that he's not lying. He was actually following you, and he actually got lost.
Hmm.
Well, this man is obviously telling the truth. He...
Are you sure? I don't like
him. I'm certain beyond a shadow of a doubt this man has really no good sense of direction in the woods.
Oh, this is true. I hate the woods. I usually stay in the cities.
I turn to him and say, well, then you best not follow us anymore. Leave immediately.
Please, I will accompany you to help you find this place that you're looking for with whoever vandals have taken this necklace, as long as you can help me get this necklace. I will pay for it if we find it. I will even pay to the general store as soon as we get back, but please, help me.
Now, you've already proven more than capable of being a complete and utter liar.
He is incompetent!
Not to mention you said you're a magic user as well, so how do we know you won't turn on us?
I have no need to turn on you, as long as I get that necklace.
I don't like him. I don't.
Can we get back to the task at hand?
Bree, what do you
think? Just leave him.
Man, I... I don't see the need to keep him around, to be honest.
You think we tie him to a tree? Leave him to struggle with the knots for a few hours?
Do you think he'd actually find his way out? That's the funny part.
That would be a little cruel, honestly.
He's not a clever man.
But being a magic user, he could potentially have a way to escape.
I suppose, but again, I just don't want to keep him.
He's a waste of time. I don't see anything for any further use for him.
I say we just move along.
Yeah, because it's really up to the shopkeeper if he wants to. He said he wants to buy the necklace. But that's not part of our duties.
Absolutely. Our duties are to recover the necklace and return it to its rightful owner.
Do you hear that? That means don't follow us.
Okay, I'll leave now. And do you allow him to leave?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, he takes several steps back to make sure you're letting him leave, and then he just like runs through the woods just away from you. He eventually vanishes from my sight.
Never seen again. Eaten by slime monsters.
Jeez.
So, our only lead now is that ravine.
So you saw the ravine. You know there was a ravine nearby. You're not exactly sure where, because an elk told you. And you also know that you saw tracks leading to the southwest. The man that you encountered went to the south.
Well, if there were tracks to the southwest, they could be potentially running... let's see. I mean, away from the ravine. So, perhaps we don't need to go to the ravine? What do you think, crew? I honestly am a bit turned around at this point.
I'm at a loss, too. I thought it was the east track where it is.
We don't have a lot of information to go off of, sadly.
Maybe should ask the dude!
Blast.
Get wrecked, nerds!
I wonder.
Your basic best bet here is to pick a direction and travel in it. You know the general right direction.
Let's go west. Let's go.
I agree. Let's just continue westward.
All right. Whoever's leading, roll a travel roll.
All right. Let's head out.
Interesting. You found a path in the forest. It's clearly a path that's trodden on quite a lot by the general local population. And go ahead and everyone make a investigation roll. Wulfgang, you're the only one who sees it, but there are a few tracks that are fresh, and they go to the west of the road.
Ah, there's something recent. Friends. Footprints. More of them. And again, like I said, they're recent. We should continue westward.
Still could be anything.
But what else do we have to go on?
We have nothing, so therefore we must follow the tracks.
I suppose it's up to you, fearless leader.
Well, I'd say we follow the tracks, and if you could perhaps follow in front of us. So I'm honestly not very much of a good tracker. Although I did receive some training. Let's just continue west.
If you choose to travel, click the travel button.
Right.
Ooh. And everyone roll perception. I will as well.
Ah, shit.
No
rolls for perception.
You all continue west, and you see that these tracks are still fresh, and they still continue in this direction. However, Bree, you notice that you're not alone. Someone is nearby. You don't know who, but they came from the direction you just came from.
Guys, I think there's someone with us.
Is it that dolt again?
I don't know.
I thought we told him to leave.
But I know we're not alone anymore.
Alright, hold on just a second. Alright, continue.
Should we check our immediate surroundings, everyone?
I'd say that's a good idea.
Yeah. So, do you all fan out and check out the area?
Sure.
It's probably the same guy, but alright.
Let's see how to do that. Roll pretty much anything at this point. Roll insight, intimidation, or not intimidation, insight, investigation, nature, survival, or perception. Anything you want.
God, I'm dumb as fuck.
Poor halfling.
Baelar, you notice that someone is definitely following you. You can see that the area that you just walked through has more tracks than your group and the tracks that you're following. You see the same thing, Wulfgang. For Agilbert, he don't see shit, but...
I'll look at the trees.
Bree.
That's a pretty flower.
Bree notices that several bushes have been pushed behind from where you traveled. Not necessarily on the path that you knocked through the woods, but They're like off to the side of the little path you traveled. So you distinctly know that something is following you, but you don't see anything.
Guys, there's absolutely someone following.
I don't know what you're talking about. But I'll take your word for it.
He said he used magic. Maybe he can go invisible.
It's possible.
You think it's the person we ran into earlier?
Could be.
I don't know.
Well,
I just see these bushes push back.
Let's see who else sees it. Baelar, Wulfgang, and Bree all see that the tracks continue to lead west.
Okay.
You also see that it's distinct, like four different shapes of feet.
Oh.
I am the worst guide.
Then let's follow those tracks.
I mean,
you guys see tracks? What?
Yes.
Let's go.
Four different feet.
That could be our guys.
Yeah, wasn't that group traveling in four?
Yeah.
Yes, let's continue on westward.
Certainly.
All right.
All right. So you come to an area where there's a lot of mud. It clearly seems someone was here recently. The sun is getting low in the sky and the woods are getting pretty dark. What do you want to do? You see that the tracks continue a little to the northwest.
Bree, do you think if you cast magic lights or dancing lights that you could, we'd be able to stealth press through the night and track what we're seeking?
I could. Would you want me to do that?
I think, honestly, I feel like we're coming so close with these tracks that
right.
It might be worth just passing through the night.
Although, I do wonder if that would attract a certain amount of unwanted attention to us. And we do still have to deal with whatever is following us.
You have a point.
Fair enough. Baelar, your thoughts on this?
I don't mind night walks. I can see clearly.
It's true, he's got night vision. He's super powerful.
Perhaps even with Baelar as the person in front, we could continue to follow the tracks and not have to worry about the...
But if something happens, you guys can't see shit.
It's true.
Maybe we set up camp and have Baelar do a night watch.
You do notice that this place has been used as a campsite. There's a really like ramshackle campsite like right where you're standing. It's just like a basic fire.
All right. Well, it's pretty obvious that the risks are too great to travel through the night. So we'll make camp for tonight then and continue our search in the morning.
If that is the case, everyone make a discovery roll.
My rolls. Why?
Now, Agilbert, I'm not saying that you see anything, but your perceptions have been higher because you remember that person was following you in the woods and you're off-put by them. And you just have a bad feeling. You have a bad feeling that something is nearby. But the night passes uneventfully. And as morning rises in the woods, what do you do?
Well, I say we pack up and try and follow see if we can track down those tracks that are leading westward again.
They head slightly northwest.
Slightly northwest.
Everyone agrees. Whoever's leading, make a travel check.
I suppose.
All right.
If the thing following us meant us harm, they'd probably have to act. Probably the same guy.
True.
You have a good point. They're probably just monitoring us.
Oh, okay.
Oh, sorry.
All right, so if you choose to travel, then you continue down the tracks. It leads to the same creek that you saw a lot of miles back. You decide to cross it, and you continue following the tracks that way. You're still heading. It's almost like a path, because whoever walked this path cleared it a lot.
Rather boisterous crowd ahead of us, I believe, and one who... a group that does not have any sort of fear of being followed. I think that if we do catch up with this group we're following, we will have an advantage.
Either way, let's just get this over with.
What was that, Chris?
If you continue, make a travel check.
Alright, let's go.
Maybe those guys are making a path. Oh. Maybe they're pathfinding.
You continue down the path and you immediately find a campsite. It is brand new. Like the fire is not cindering anymore, but you can tell it was used last night, as about the same time you were camping.
Oh, we have to be close.
Is there anything in the immediate area I can investigate or forage over?
If you want to, go ahead and do an investigation or nature check. You find some berries, but nothing of use.
Darn. At least these might be decent to eat.
I'll do a check of my own.
Nope. You don't find still shit. Dumb. You find a pine cone.
Oh, hell yeah. This for breakfast.
That's a decent pine cone.
I like that pine cone.
Maybe we should up the pace a little.
You can do athletics check with your travel check.
Yep. Well, does anyone else want to scout out the area?
I'll do it.
Lead on?
So just...
If you want to check, you can check with investigation or nature. Or survival.
We're losing time.
So you don't find shit. You see the same pine cone that he saw.
Look, it's this pine cone.
Pine cone.
It's definitely a pine cone.
We gotta go.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Alright, you follow the path a little further on. Everyone make a perception check.
I'm not gonna perceive shit.
Oh my god.
Don't talk about Bree. Oh god.
Hey!
And now, everyone make really a second perception check.
What?
Oh my god.
Hey.
I'm gonna cry.
Not even a crit for me.
Rolls a gold.
Not nat 20. Oh yes.
Alright, so let's parse this out. Wulfgang and Baelar, you see along the copse of trees, very far in front of you, about maybe 600 meters, there are people there. You see them. You can't really make them out, but they're out there. It's a group, and that's all you can tell from here. You can't really count the numbers. Agilbert, you distinctly know there's someone behind you. You spin around, and you can't see anything, but they're there.
Oh, jeez.
Agilbert, what's wrong?
Baelar, you also, you don't see anything, but you hear something.
Crack.
Guys, there's someone right here.
I don't see anything.
You both know that it's a fair distance off, but they're nearby. You'd probably say within, like, a 500-meter radius, but you're not sure which direction.
So depending on what speed they were going, they would be right on top of us.
Agilbert knows they're toward the northeast, but they're a pretty, like, they're a long way away. It would take, like, a long sprint to get to you.
They would, okay.
We don't have enough time to waste with this.
I think you, like...
I'm tired of this travel.
The way that Agilbert heard it is like a huge flock of birds just, like, started chattering, and they all leapt through the trees, mm-hmm. So you heard it in that direction. You happened to look, and you saw something, but you don't know what it was.
Guys, I think this is more than just one individual following us. I have a very, very bad feeling about what's coming behind us.
And remember, you do see a group of people in front of you.
Ugh, torn between what's becoming behind us and what is in front of us. I feel like our goal is in front of us. but we need to be wary, and I believe we should set up a person as a rear guard, at least.
So you say that person is 500 meters behind? Or whatever is behind?
About that distance.
About that distance to the northeast. Like, you didn't get to see it. Agilbert had a better view on it, but he didn't really see anything. He just saw, like, movement, and he heard all the birds. You didn't hear the birds, but you noticed the direction where they were making the noise from.
Would there be time to set up a hunting trap?
I mean, you could do that. You do see the group in front of you. They don't seem to be doing much at the moment. They seem to be, like, taking a break from the travel.
Okay. That, Baelar, that's actually quite a good idea, I would say. And I have my hunting trap that I could set up.
I have one, too.
Oh, really? Would you prefer to set that up and then catch up with us?
Yeah, you guys go ahead. I'll set a trap.
I also could create a certain illusion.
Ah.
For a pursuer.
For perspective, the group in front of you is about 200 to 300 meters in front of you.
Oh, they're not very far away at all.
Yeah. Like, you can see them. They haven't seemed to take any notice of you. There's a lot of, like, greenery around, so they can't see.
So we have some time to set up a trap. I'd say, Baelar, if you could set up that trap, that would be perfect. And then, North, if you could... Wulfgang, if you could further bait that trap with an illusion, that would be in our advantage. And that way we could perhaps worry less about what's coming behind us and focus on the task at hand.
I understand. Baelar, if you could set up the trap, please.
I produce the hunting trap from my backpack and put it down right in the middle of the road.
Done and done. It's like a huge bear trap, and you set it wherever you think is most useful.
And I attach it to a tree.
There you go.
And I cast Minor Illusion to show an illusion of him continuing to set up the trap.
Does that use a spell slot?
That is a cantrip.
All right. It is. It just vanishes. It's gone.
My cantrip vanishes?
It's basically...
Immediately as it was casted?
I mean, it takes a minute for you to cast the spell, but it's just... It's like it's concealed by your magic.
Oh, you mean the trap is concealed?
Yeah.
What we were thinking was...
Oh, no. Yeah. I was... The trap's still there, but I'm talking about an illusion where Baelar is still setting the trap up.
Oh, okay. So he's like trying to set up the trap and you're trying to make sure he doesn't get seen?
That our pursuer might assume that we're still stuck there working on that.
Okay.
Yeah, the idea is we have a person behind and for the other group behind us to notice and then to try and sneak up upon. In the meantime, we're actually far ahead of them.
Oh, okay. So like fake images of you, basically.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Let's see. All right. So you did that. You had images of you guys setting the traps for several hours. Or several minutes, rather. So, like, you know, that image will last you a solid, like, 30 minutes, as long as it took to set up the trap. The group is still... They've gone a few hundred meters ahead of you. They haven't made much progress.
I'd say it's time to move quickly. Always have the illusion up.
All right, let's go forward, then.
All right, so you come upon a group. Let's see if they notice you. Let us see. Oops, that's not how you do it. Oh, they don't notice you at all. You distinctly see a group. They are all clothed in black with various black clothing and cloaks. They seem to be chitting and chatting all about. They're just walking through the woods. No problems.
Might I do an investigation check to see if there's any pouches or satchels?
You don't even need to. There's plenty of pouches and satchels.
Oh, fantastic. How about a perception check to see if any of them are wearing the specific item that we're looking for?
Go for it. You don't see anyone wearing anything in particular.
They're all naked underneath them robes.
Maybe. You don't know. But they are distinctly clad in black, and they are heading in the direction that you were told they were heading in.
All right. We have to come up with a plan to try and confront these group of four. Because these match the description of who we're told to look for.
They right. seem to, with the black, you do see, let me see real quick. Let's see. Who are these people?
Could I make a perception check to see if one of them is an orc?
Go for it.
All right. Nope, I'm dumb.
they're all clothed in black. That's all you see.
Baelar, what do your elf eyes see?
Can my elf eyes see something?
You distinctly see that...
There is at least one bigger than the others.
There is one bigger than the others. He is not an orc, but he has, like, palish skin. It's very similar to the orcs from the northwest. But he's distinctly not an orc. Otherwise, as you remember from the Tavern Keep and from Jonas, they match the description of what you've been told. Almost to a T.
Alright.
Should we... I don't know. Just go in there? Or should we stealthily go around them and search through their things? I mean, what would you say? I mean, we could certainly try to intimidate them, but I don't know. The manner of their garb, I would think brute force might not be the right idea.
Fair enough. Baelar, I always know you're up for a fight. If it does come to that, but I think that Wulfgang is correct in this manner. We should attempt to elect sort of a speaker, perhaps. To try and investigate, and that could be perhaps a distraction as the others surround the camp.
It's a thing you could do.
I could just go in there and tackle one.
You could do that too.
I mean, I certainly understand how you feel, Baelar, but I just don't trust. I don't trust the way that Trest and their movements, like, it's too secretive. This is too easy. I don't feel comfortable. But how do you feel about all this, Bree?
I don't feel comfortable either. Perhaps I could try and charm them a bit, or distract them?
I mean, that's certainly a thing you could do. How does everyone else feel about that idea?
Well, obviously the biggest threat that poses is putting her in direct danger in case the people in front of us decide to turn on her. Is that a risk you're willing to take, Bree?
I mean, if you guys are...
I'm confident in our ability that if need be, we can come
I can go. I can go talk to them and you guys go around.
Ah, you are a big intimidating fellow. I suppose you could go try and talk to them, but just please don't let it devolve into mindless tackling.
You believe in me?
I do. It's just I don't quite believe in your thuggishness.
I'm a charming man. People like me.
I never said that wasn't the case.
Alright,
just know
right.
how you get.
Regardless, Baelar, let's put into plans.
Let's throw him in. let's let him take point, I suppose.
So the plan is to approach the people with Blargh in the front and everyone else sneaking around?
That's correct.
Yes.
All right. Everyone roll a stealth roll.
Boy.
Please, God.
Oh, damn! My God, this is the best plan that has ever been executed.
Like Dear I said, God, I'm charming man. Hold on. The attention.
Okay, stream can see how great your rolls are. Dear God, that is fantastic. Let me show you how this is going to go down. All right, here's the scenario we got going down. Here's the four people. They're over here. And we're going to have Blargh coming straight at them like this. You guys move where you would like to move. You can go any direction around him or around them.
Nothing. Do we just do it in our yep. minds?
Or? No. Okay. Wait, can you not see?
No, we're still in the village.
Nothing. Boop, there you go.
Hey.
Wait,
just gotta wait for the background assets to load.
There's nothing there. You're fine.
Oh.
Oh.
Ah.
Like I said, we're going as simple as that. That's the woods right there. That's it. Look at him go.
All right. Woo.
Bree,
so
you come with me.
Before we start, everyone move to where they would like around these people.
Agilbert, you're on your own. Me and Bree will move over to the side.
Okay, so this is the path here.
Yeah, you're no longer on necessarily a path. It was more just like their footsteps through the earth.
Okay. Well, I have more than enough confidence in my sneaking, so I'm going to be right next to him here.
Yeah. So, once everyone's ready, let me know.
Ready.
Alright, and this time distances do apply, so if you want to get the correct like distance, use the ruler tool. So if you want to be further or closer, that's all up to you.
They are within range.
What are we checking for?
You're just kind of checking, like, how far close you want to be to them.
Range, just in case you need to use an ability or something like that.
Get a little bit closer.
Alright, so you all are hiding in their copses of trees all around them. Blargh approaches, and they... Let's see if they see you. Let's see if they even notice. Yeah, they notice eventually. As soon as you, like, crack over a big log, they all turn towards you. What are you doing there?
Oh, hey. I think we were looking for you guys.
Looking for
us? I'm not too sure.
What are you looking for?
Well, I might have heard that you took something from someone.
Took something? Says this dude right here, this guy in particular. He's not too happy about your line of questioning.
Can I run an insight to see if he's violent?
He seems nervous.
Alright. Yeah, someone kinda stole something from the store, general store yesterday, in the town nearby, and they kind of saw four person. Would you happen to know them?
Everyone roll initiative.
Oh shit, that's me too.
There we go.
forgot I had to click on my person.
Oops.
Ah, dang.
Oh,
best blade plans have not worked! Oh, shit!
I'm thinking too much about my speech right now.
Alright, so you tried to just talk to them out of it. As soon as you mention the general store, this dude rushes you straight out, and he's going to attack you. Let us get this turn order in order. because he is not happy with your line of questioning. And he's going to roll. Boop. Boop. And that's plus two. Doop. He instantly deals you 7 hit points of damage.
Wow.
This guy immediately knows what the fuck you're here for, and he just slashes you with the sword.
Jesus Christ.
How much health do you have with that knife?
What was that?
So he hit me with that 9.
Oh wait, yeah, he drew 9. Oh shit, yeah, so he slashes you, but he didn't actually hit you. Yes, yeah, he took a nasty swing at you, but you dodged it.
As I dodge it, I just go, whoa, what's with the big anger there?
He yells,
I just want a friendly conversation.
He yells, get them, and they're immediately moving toward you. So you got this other guy. He's gonna roll. Oh, that guy hits you.
Shit.
For certain. But what does he hit you for? He hits you for a solid 6.
Ouch.
Boom.
And then this guy, he's gonna go over here. He's also gonna roll for you. Uh-huh. And what's your AC?
14.
He clinks against your armor but misses.
Jesus.
I don't actually have one.
Well, that's fine. He clinks against your physical skin and it doesn't work. All right. What is the turn order? Let's actually clear the turn order. Boop, boop. Where are y'all's initiatives?
Well, the initiative was there already.
I'll figure it out as we go. ACS, it's up to you.
It's ACS, Beckens, and you know what both of us for.
Well, I was planning on trying to attack the group with my Thunder Wave. However, that area of attack is now
on
here. They're out of range. That so the only true. Person I could attack with that would be this one right here.
That's true. You could do it, though. Kind He's all alone.
Kind of a waste, I feel. But that would push them closer to where Wulfgang is, so perhaps he could get a... Although I don't know. Let's see. I could move at least one square over and then take a shot, correct? That would get me this right here.
You could always strike Blargh in your area of effect if you wanted to.
Please don't.
It's an option.
I think actually it's a 15 square foot or cubed foot cube. So if I moved to here and then moved to here.
Well, you've got 25 move space. So you
I had 25?
Yeah, you can move a long distance, basically.
Oh, wow.
You guys set up really well for this. So you can cast from where you're standing. They wouldn't even know you're there.
I see. So this is 5 foot.
Yeah.
So then...
Like, the only person they see is Blargh. They don't see anyone else.
I'm going to just attack, like to actually have my attack land here. So that just the outside affected area will catch these
fair.
Two here.
Alright, is that your choice?
Yep, so I'm going to move... let's see here, because the range of my attack is...
It's pretty long, as far as I know. It's probably like 30 feet.
It says range is 15 foot cube.
Oh. Well, no, that's the size.
Oh, I see. Okay, no, then I'll just cast it from right. I'll cast it from right here.
Cast it up.
Okay.
Let's see that damage.
Am I in
there? Damn. No, he planned it to where you're not. So it's only hitting these two. It's not hitting this guy next to you. So each of them take 14. And dear God, both of these guys are just electrocuted to death. Because that was some intense damage.
Hot damn, we're saved.
You just cooked them. They're gone.
Nice.
So
you basically just almost got perfect rolls.
Holy crap.
I just imagine him like sliding on his knees and doing his thing and
yeah, so they were chopping at you. Only a couple of them like actually did any damage. And then immediately two people just vaporize in front of you and they get thrown into the trees.
Jesus Christ.
All right.
And who's up next? It is...
Beckens.
Yeah.
Am I able to ask Baelar how he's doing right now, health-wise?
You can yell at him, but he seems to be okay. He took a nick.
Okay.
He took a solid nick to the arm.
And don't forget, making that sound will probably grab the attention of the other guys.
It's true. Right.
But I can't do anything from range, so I have to step out of the boundaries, I think.
Your best laid plans already got ruined, so maybe that's not the worst idea.
Alright, should I just start attacking this guy?
You can do it.
Do it.
Approach him and do it.
Alright.
Hit him up.
Here we go.
Do a solid nine damage. You stab him right in the side. He didn't even see you coming, and it hurt. Like, he's bleeding profusely, but he's not dead.
Okay, he's not dead.
He is not dead.
So, no, me and Nord both out of four.
You and you, what happened? What?
Me and Blargh both rolled a four for our initiative.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. So, you choose. You get to choose who goes first.
Go ahead, Mark.
All right. So, I don't really want to kill this guy, so I know there's a thing that we can say if we want to kill someone or not.
There are no rules about killing in the Watch.
No, but I mean, in D&D, you can say I don't want to kill.
Yeah, if you want to do like a non-violent take down, you can do that.
Alright, so I'll strike the guy right in front of me, but I don't want to kill him.
Make it happen.
So let's say I just hit him with the other end of my stick.
Jeez, so much damage, holy shit! Alright, you basically cut his leg off. It's just gone. It's just straight up gone.
No, I don't want to kill him, so I just smash his knees.
All right,
it's
so
just a flesh wound.
You take the back end of your axe and you just smack the side of his leg with the iron part, and it just breaks. It breaks immediately.
How did I do 11 damage?
This is kind of stupid. How fast you took this gang down?
I've got 1d10 damage. How did I do 11?
Alright, this last guy's remaining. So this guy, I'm gonna leave him here because he's down, but I'll spin him the other way.
Wait, maybe he's taking rage into consideration? Yeah, I've got a +3 out of nowhere.
That's true, okay. What is your normal attack then?
It's 1d10, and it says plus 3 here, so only 8.
So only 8 damage? Let me double check. Yeah, okay. So if that's the case, you smacked him on the knee. It hurt. He's not feeling good, but he's still up.
Wait a minute. How do you figure 8?
I looked at my damage.
Wait. I'm sorry. Say that again.
Go in my damage. Hover above the 11. It says 1d10 plus 3 plus 0.
Yeah. So, take out so you rolled an 8 plus 3. That's why you get the 11.
Yeah, but oh yeah, that +3 is my strength, right? Yeah, okay, it's your bonus. Okay. Yeah, okay.
Alright, so his knees are broken, nerd!
You fucking wrecked his shit. He is bleeding out profusely.
He's not bleeding, but it hurts. There's one dude left.
Bleeding from...
That's on me, I suppose.
That's on you.
Gonna take my chance and light crossbow him.
Alright, do it. All right, you definitely hit. It snags him right in the chest. He doesn't know where it comes from, but it hurts.
I suppose I'll leave that to you guys. That's it for me.
And that's the end of the turn order, correct?
So now that's the guy's turn?
Let's see. One second. Alright. Yeah, it's the guy's turn.
Chris, in case you don't know, you're muted.
I'm muted? The muted shit! I fixed it. okay, yeah, so it is the guy's turn. He's gonna move straight to Bree, because she seems to be the biggest threat, because she just came out of nowhere and just killed this dude. So, he is going to attack you. What is he going to attack with? Let's see. This guy is a little different from the rest.
Oh.
Actually, he's going to stay right where he is.
Oh.
Cool. I think.
Might not be a good idea, but a good thing.
And I actually didn't roll that in order. Yep, he certainly hits you, and he hits you for 6 damage. He shoots you with a crossbow.
I'm almost dead again.
So you got nailed in the back with a crossbow.
This one's down ACS, so...
Say what?
The guy in the black cloak next to them is down.
Yeah, he's down.
Yeah,
he's down. So the only actual target is the dude.
So it's up to you what you do.
Who's it now?
Who is first? Let's see.
Actually,
what you notice...
It's the Agilbert's turn.
It is not Agilbert's turn, and I'll tell you why in just a moment.
Oh god, the person who's following us.
Let's get an image for that dude. There he is.
Oh, Jesus.
So, this dude...
This nerd.
He runs up. You distinctly all recognize that it's the same dude from before. He is here.
Him!
I'll go here. And we're going to do a thing.
Does he have a trap mark on his leg?
No.
Oh.
He does not. Interesting. Yes. And... we're going to do this. Oops. Bree, this man just healed you for 6 health points.
Oh, thank God.
What?
Now, it is this nerd's turn, and this guy's booking it. Run away.
Come back, you bitch.
And he actually runs off the map here, so we're going to start pretending. He is about 30 feet away. And let's see if he does a thing properly. Oh, God. You distinctly see him pull something from a pouch and throw it to this direction. Over that way.
Oh.
And now he's just booking it this direction.
So you said he's about 30 feet from the place he was?
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, he ran a full 30 feet.
All right, so he'd be approximately 55 feet from me?
Yep.
So he's still in range.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, I could acid splash him. Oh, jeez.
Aim for the ankles.
I mean, it's not my turn.
Alright, who's up first?
It's Agilbert.
Yeah, Gilbert.
So wait, I'm a little confused. So is he not actually this distance from me? Is he actually
he
like
is 35
behind?
Feet.
He is like 15 feet.
From you, he's 35 feet.
Would I be able to move and then cast a spell?
Yes.
In that case,
Move as close as you want. You can move a max of 25 feet.
That's it? That's close enough. I cast Tasha's Hideous Laughter on him.
Oh, no.
Duration 1 minute.
What kind of check does that require?
I think it's actually, it's an enchantment.
But it's wisdom check,
I believe so. Let's just double check. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Wisdom check.
What is his wisdom? Oh, he's not wise at all.
Actually,
say so first.
I'm sorry. I guess I don't understand properly what his wisdom check would be to.
His wisdom is his stats, so you can't see what his stats are.
Okay.
So, you cast your spell, but you did not affect him. He's still booking it.
Damn.
Next up.
Bree.
This guy's booking it out into the forest. What you gonna do? You also have this guy who just randomly healed you.
Yeah. But he chucked something the other direction.
Yeah, that guy did distinctly throw something.
I wanna go check that out.
You could probably find it if you looked.
Okay.
But it's over that way. But it's a long distance away, and you're still in combat.
Oh.
So let's see how far away that is. That's probably like 60 feet in that direction.
And you can only move 25, but if you take dash, you can make another 25.
Wait, what?
You're an halfling, so yep. Your move distance is 25 feet. And if you use a dash action, you can move another 25 feet.
You could do that. It would take up all your actions, though. You couldn't do anything else.
It's fine by me.
So you want to run in the direction of the necklace?
Yeah.
All right. You run in that direction. We'll move you as close as you can get with this map. Whoop! That's the wrong person. Whoop! So you have not quite made it to where the thing was thrown. But you're almost there.
It's fine.
Next up is, I think it was Baelar first? Yeah.
So, I get to 30, let's say here. And it was 55 from me?
Yeah, he's like 10 feet in front of you.
Alright then. I take out the javelin.
Uh-oh.
Chuck it.
Make it happen.
No, actually, I've got two hand axes in my belt.
That's also a thing you can do.
And I throw it.
Hits him for 7. Wait. Hold that thought. Not yet. I'm getting over anxious. Does not hit him. The axe goes flying. It bounces off his armor, but he does not get affected. It is now Wulfgang.
Alright, so...
This guy has... he wants nothing to do with you, but there's also this weird dude who just showed up.
You gotta remember, I don't care for this man that healed... that healed her, so I'm going to... move closer. And how far is he away from me at this point?
He is about 15 feet, so he's pretty 15? Close. Yeah, after that move, he's about 15.
Easy. I look at my cantrips, and I'm gonna cast Acid Splash again on him.
Acid Splash again, do it. Do you just cast that, or is it like, do you have to roll?
It's a cantrip.
Interesting.
Yeah, a target must succeed on a dexterity saving throw.
Oh, okay.
Take 1d6 acid damage.
That makes more sense. He is not very dexterous, though.
Is he?
Oh, but he just dances around that acid.
Oh,
you don't want
damn.
Nothing to do with it.
He just let it go.
The fuck out. Nope.
Well, then he better stay gone.
All right. It is the wizard's, or no, it's the bandit's turn. He moves way over here, so he's way off the map at this point. But that's where he goes. It is the wizard's turn next. He moves right over here. He does. Neither of them do anything. You scare the fuck out of those bandits. They're just peacing out.
So, comes back to Bree's turn. No, not Bree's. Agilbert's turn.
Yep. What you doing? ACS.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Got a little distracted. So at this point, the other bandit, whatever, is way off that way. We got dead guy right here, and now we have wizard in front of us.
Yep. He doesn't seem to be very concerned with you, the wizard dude.
And I'm sorry, Bree, were you successful in trying to find whatever object was thrown in that direction?
Not yet.
I am not there yet.
Right there. Then, if this guy's not concerned about me, I'm not concerned about him. Well, Bree, are you still? No, you're not injured anymore. I'm going to just go this direction and attempt to find that object that was thrown.
All right, investigation. You could also do perception if you'd prefer.
Well, I'm dumb as fuck, so it's really not gonna
Does he have advantage since it's not hidden or something? It's just laying
there.
Nope,
it fell somewhere out there. He didn't really see where it went.
All right.
Bree only saw the general direction as well. Ah, you didn't see shit.
I'm so stupid.
It went somewhere in that general direction, as in the general direction of northeast.
Wait, oh, goddamn. Duh, where'd it go, guys?
So, is it my turn?
Yes.
Can I do perception?
Yes.
Fuck. Yes,
it went somewhere in there. I think it hit a bush, maybe a tree. Maybe it just flew off into the sky, you're not sure. You can move if you want.
Where am I? Oh. So, just went in like, where's my ruler? Like, this direction-ish?
Yeah, it went like northeast of here, it's not on the map anymore, so we'll just say you like you moved that way. If you want to move northeast, that's fine.
I can't, so I mean, there's no boxes anymore.
Yeah, that's just the size of the map.
I'll just move to like here.
Yep.
Yeah, there we go.
So you can check more on your next turn. Next up is Baelar.
I will run toward the dude and tackle him.
Which dude? That dude. Oh shit.
Yeah.
Strength check. Oh,
hey,
shit! That guy's screwed! Wait, that was a strength save. Do an actual strength check.
Oh, shit. Where's that?
That is in not your core stats, but the other one. Or do athletics, rather.
Oh, okay.
Let's see if he dodges. Oh, yeah, you tackle him. He's gone. You pin him to the ground. No, please, stop! Wolfgang, is all you...
Not a step further, old man.
Okay. So, while Baelar takes care of that guy, I'm going to... Hold on. Gonna move over here. And I will do a investigation check to see if I find the item that was thrown.
Okay, so you abandon the bandit?
Yeah, I'm done with him.
All right, bandit is gone.
Because Especially because I see the wizard.
He just peaced out.
I don't want none of that.
Go ahead and make your perception.
Investigation. Okay.
Look at that. You look around for a minute. The combat has ended. Y'all just kind of chill out for a minute. And as you look around, while Blargh has that dude pinned, you see the glint of a necklace in the bush.
Right between the legs of Bree and...
Oh my.
Basically, you're not wrong.
Do pardon my intrusion, but lady and gentlemen, I believe I found what we're looking for.
I found a pinecone.
You keep that for safekeeping. I bet you'll need it later on. Good job, though. I believe in all of us.
All right, you found it's distinctly the necklace that was exactly as described to you, and you have a wizard in your possession.
And a guy that's still living?
You're still holding him down at the moment.
No, but the other guy didn't kill him.
The other guy just peaced out. He wanted nothing to do with it.
The one down there, I just broke his
knee. He's holding his knee. He's like, So he's in great pain, but he's still there.
I believe we have two things to deal with. Who do we want to handle first?
I mean, that guy here doesn't want to harm us, so...
But you know I don't like him. You know I don't like that wizard.
Well, deal with him then. I don't fucking care.
Please, please don't deal with me.
I dealt with my job. Why are you still here? Leave us be.
I need that necklace, please.
Why do you need it?
It's tell for me. My own concern.
You will tell me now. Should I roll intimidation?
Sure. Fuck. Oh man, you're not intimidating as fuck. He doesn't give a fuck. He's just like, I need the necklace. You don't understand.
I don't understand. How about you teach me, seeing as I just wish to absorb knowledge as we wizards do?
I wish to absorb the knowledge of that necklace. I will pay for it. I will go back with you to town and pay the owner of it.
Absorb its knowledge. Is there more to this necklace, or are you just using a turn of phrase?
There is more to this necklace than you understand.
Then... I'm not sure I trust it with a stranger.
Well, anyway, Wolfgang, this necklace belongs to the shopkeep, and the shopkeep will decide if he wants to sell it or not, so let's just get back.
That's not of his concern. I'm trying to teach him that. Now, what did you plan on doing with our broken and battered friend?
Well, I mean, we're bringing him back, I guess.
You could take him back.
Is he in any condition to move?
You could carry him. He wouldn't be in trouble.
Have to make sure justice is served.
Yes.
We justice. Serve plenty of justice.
Yes, the two gentlemen that we, eviscerated. And
dispatched.
The one who's probably peeing himself all the way back to his encampment, whatever it may be.
They'll pay for their crimes!
Yes, and we will roleplay the actual courtroom.
Objection!
Overruled!
Damn it. So I go back to that guy, and I look at how he's clothes. I look at his clothes.
Mm-hmm.
And see if we can. If I recognize something from when the watch taught us. Like, one of the groups.
He doesn't seem like anyone in particular. He seems like a dude.
Alright, so no special cloaks or something?
He has no special markings on him. Nothing you would learn in training.
You! Heathen!
What do you want?
Why are you here? And why did you steal the necklace?
I just fucking blew up in an explosion, mate. I don't know what the fuck is happening.
I press on his crushed knees with my foot
and
say,
please, no.
The man asked you a question. Can I roll intimidation with that?
If you want to.
God, I think
he's a very low check. Oh god, he's fucked. We just wanted the necklace, please stop!
I guess that answers.
Have you seen that necklace? It's worth a fortune!
How?
I saw that man. Sell that necklace to the other townskeep, dude. Fuck, it hurts out.
We could make that hurt a lot more if you stop answering.
Stop! It's an expensive necklace. We wanted it.
Well, if he's not going to give us answers, then I suppose we will just bring him back to town. And hopefully he'll be dealt with accordingly. Unless you have another answer.
What are you doing with the wizard, by the way?
What happened to the road?
Don't question the road. It's fine. Everything's fine. But what are you doing with that wizard?
I'm personally walking away.
So you don't even care about the wizard?
I want him to leave it be, but he won't leave it be, so therefore I
so
have the...
So, is anyone watching the wizard?
Well, not particularly. I'm... Right now, I'm just tying
it. Agilbert Bree, what are you doing with the wizard?
I personally am still concerned because it seems like he's desperate to get his hands on this necklace. And I'm not so sure. Like, as, even though he's healed Bree, I'd prefer to at least question him and find out why he's so interested in it. Perhaps this is not a necklace that anyone should own, but should be possibly locked up because it could be potentially dangerous if it falls into the wrong hands.
So what are you going to do with him?
I'm going to threaten him by saying if he doesn't behave, that Baelar is going to break his knees too.
Oh no! Please no! Are you taking me into custody?
Yes. You will follow us.
Oh no.
He was already gonna follow us to the merchants.
Well, this time he's gonna follow in handcuffs.
Let's see how he feels like that. Oh yeah, he gave up. He doesn't even need handcuffs. He just submits to you.
All right.
Submits.
I still don't trust him. I still don't care what we do. I want him to be done.
Look, we can lock him up if he gets unruly.
I suppose we found what we've needed. Let us go with all of our bounties.
All right, so you're heading back to town?
Unless there's anything else we want to see.
Wants to look if one of those guys had something.
You can check. This is your time.
I'm gonna check.
Who are you gonna check?
Well, firstly, this guy right here, if he's got something.
He has a pouch of gold, some just a variety of items, nothing unusual.
I'm taking all that, and the other one just they've just been vaporized, right?
The other people, they are not actually vaporized. They just got super shocked, and they got thrown around. They just had the same sort of knickknacks, nothing important.
All right. So, I'm getting back my axe that I drew, and I'm ready to go.
Anything else to be done in this forest?
I am personally done with this forest. I'm done with everything it's brought to us. Let's get the job finished, please.
Bree, anything?
No. I'm good.
Then, that means you head back to town. As simple as that. You take this poor guy who has fucking legs beat open, but you limp him back to town. He gets back all right. You hand him over to Jonas, who's of the Firewatch, and he's gonna just lock him up into a room and call up the knights to come deal with him eventually. What do you do with the wizard?
I feel like
if you'd rather deal with the necklace first, that's also acceptable.
The necklace first. I would say,
yeah.
I feel like it's something we'd have to discuss on the way back.
Yeah, what would you like to do with the necklace?
Honestly, I'd prefer it if we... I mean, if a wizard is so interested in it, I almost want to see if, like, the head mage at the academy, or academy, but the watch could examine it and make sure it's not dangerous in some way. Or even just have Wulfgang take a look at it.
I do have some knowledge in the arcana, if that's what you wish to ask of me.
If you would.
Roll arcana check.
Do it. Make it happen. It's a necklace. It's a necklace, and it's distinctly... You can tell there's magic in it, but you don't know a whole lot about it.
I think there is something to this. I feel it, but I don't know what it is. We should handle this with a much more veteran hand. We should give this to more veteran hands. I do feel like the wizard following us, there was a purpose to that, but we have to rid ourselves of both people before we can safely bring this into more knowledgeable hands.
And perhaps if we did return the item to its owner before we did that, we could even have it disenchanted, and therefore rendering it just a expensive piece of jewelry and no danger to anyone.
I mean, as long as that was the actual shopkeeper's intent. I don't know how much knowledge he actually has of this thing.
True.
Well,
we should bring it back to the watch.
I say we bring it back to the shopkeep, yeah. Tell him the situation, and then if he wants us to take care of it, we bring it to the watch.
So who do you want to tell first, the watch or the shopkeep?
I second Baelar's idea.
Honestly, I mean, it's really not our concern. We're in it for the purse. Not really. Personally, I'm in it for the purse rather than the consent or the concern for the general public.
I suppose, but there's something to this. I really wish I could know. Well, you know.
You can always see if the shopkeep is willing to get rid of the necklace.
Yes, I could. We could talk to him. I guess. Lead on.
So, all right. You go back to town. You hand off this nerdy dude with the broken legs. He's gone forever. And you talk to the shopkeep. You mentioned that the necklace is magical. And he asks what you think would be best to do with it.
Well, I personally think, being the actual wizard here who has knowledge in many magics, I think if you would allow us, sir, to bring it back to our headquarters, watch headquarters, and have some of our veteran wizards and mages and scholars actually look into this and investigate further. If anything, we can see what its magic is. We can disenchant it if need be, but if it's not too severe, we can leave it as it is. And from there, we can either give it back to you, or if it were to be a larger spectacle than we imagine, we can handle it appropriately.
Absolutely. That sounds like the best plan.
Oh, well, I very much appreciate your agreement, sir. So we shall take this, and we will keep in touch with you.
Yeah, he asks you for an IOU, and you sign it with your names, like all four of you do. That way, he knows who actually signed off on that from the watch. And then you take it back to the watch. Do you go consult? Do you talk to Arnold?
Yes.
All right. You present it to Arnold in the.
Mine show it to Armin.
To Armin. All right. As soon as you go into the mage quarters, Armin is not there. He's doing something else. But Arnold is there, and you all discuss with him. What do you say?
Arnold, do you see this necklace we've brought with us from the mission at hand?
Let's see what he sees in it. And let's do that with advantage, because he's good at what he does. That's what
there
I thought. I thought he knew what he was talking about. He looked at it and he's like, I'm not sure about that shit. And then he thinks again. He's like, oh, wait, now I know. Ah, yes, I know exactly what this is. And I know exactly the properties it has. Thank you for returning it to me.
Returning it?
by returning, he meant, like, giving it to him.
Okay, because I was going to say you once owned it.
He fucked up. He missed.
Duh!
So, but no. pray tell, what exactly, what are the properties of this necklace?
This necklace seems to have a strange enchantment upon it. I'm not sure what it is, but I have a good guess. I will have to research it with my team. And maybe next time you drop by, we can discuss it further.
Oh, I would love to. I would love to actually learn the magics concealed within.
We shall soon see. Thank you very much for what you've done. Please report to Lucas for further instructions.
Thank you very much.
By the way, Arnold, can I just say?
Yes?
I found a pine cone.
Do you hand him the pine cone?
Yeah.
Oh, good God, yes.
He takes the pine cone.
Can you examine this?
He does indeed examine it. Yes, it seems this needs further study. I will investigate this. You can discuss this with me next time.
Does he just pat him on the head?
You can do an insight check to see how he feels about this pine cone, if you feel like it. Anyone can do that. Anyone who wants to.
Oh. The one time I get an intelligent roll.
Does anyone want another insight check?
Pinecone feels.
Does anyone else want to know?
There we go.
Does anyone else want to know what he thinks of the pinecone?
Not pine. All
right. Bree doesn't know what he thinks of the pine cone, but both Wulfgang and Agilbert immediately know that he has zero interest in this pine cone, but he daintily sets it on his desk.
Listen, Agilbert, you tried. That's all that matters.
I really thought you would like that. That seemed interesting.
You just got to keep trying, my friend.
So, I gotta find more pine cones.
Later, you discuss with Lucas, and he thanks you for your good service for the watch. And he has a special surprise to you, but before that, he makes sure to deposit in your safe box within each of your dormitories a healthy sum of 55 gold apiece.
Woo! Hell yeah, rolling in it.
You also know that from your travels that you feel like you've learned a lot. You've learned a lot about investigation, tracking people overland, and fearing the dangers. You also did really good at just demolishing a huge group of actually skilled bandits, which I did not
think
like you would destroy in one hit.
Baelar feel like he's learned something when talking to people.
It's true. You talked to a lot of people. That was a very investigatory quest.
And things went up to fight. Next time I'll just rushing into fight. Got it.
It's not necessarily the worst plan, but
sometimes it works out.
From your experiences, you know that you have grown a level, and you are all level 2.
Yeah.
How much XP did that give us?
I just gave a lot, but you're level 2. That's all that really matters.
I want the mats.
So that means after session, you get to upgrade your character in a variety of ways. There's not too many upgrades, but you're smarter now.
I want the Madden.
Exactly. And after Lucas told you, or after you told Lucas what happened, he reminds you to come to the Grand Hall at the end of the week. As you do, you are greeted with all the variety of the watch who happen to be at Kendall Hall on that weekend. And Panthea is there to give you the official cloak of the watch. You are now,
yes. Oh, man,
you are now official
of
keepers of the watch.
Yes!
Yay!
And as the coronation ceremony ends, Lucas reminds you the duty for your first quest is next Monday.
He said duty.
Yeah.
Yay!
GG, you didn't die.
GG, you nerds.
I almost died twice.
You did almost die twice. Okay.
I watched it right in the eyes. Yay.
I'm not sure I'm more concerned with whether you almost died twice straight out or you killed pretty much all the group straight out.
Our group is too strong.
I've been face to face with a lot of enemies there. Like two times against three enemies at once. I feel like my group really saved me.
Did pretty freaking good, not gonna lie.
Yay!
But that's the end. That's the first session.
How much gold did we get from the bandits?
Did you turn the gold in, or did you pocket the gold for yourself? The watch taught you rules. You can do as you please.
I split it between us, I guess.
That depends on all you. Do you want to give up the gold to the watch, or do you want to keep the gold for yourself?
I don't need gold right now.
No rules, no mercy. No socks, no shoes.
Who wants to keep it? That's the real question.
He never told us we had to turn in the gold, so I keep it.
All right. So, Agilbert and Wulfgang, what do you want to do with your gold?
I'd like to give off a portion.
To who?
To the watch.
Oh, you're just going to give it back to the watch? That's fine.
A portion of it, yes.
Mine goes into my drinking fund.
Okay.
So you have a problem.
Agilbert, Bree, and Baelar all pocket their money. North gives it up to the watch. So North gets 55 gold, and everyone else gets 56 gold.
Yes!
Hot damn.
They didn't have a whole lot of money. That's why they probably stole the necklace.
Hot diggity damn.
Noobs.
And
even
that's
though they're
it.
A skilled bandit clan.
How you feel? You completed your first quests?
This was a great session.
Great.
It's really fun.
I'm glad. But
I thought that
I'm
might go south really quick, a lot faster.
Oh man, like that thunder wave was really good. You like those bandits were not weak, but you pretty much got perfect rolls and it outright killed them.
Got lucky.
Speaking of perfect rolls, fucking intelligence rolls.
Right. God damn.
The bandit that ran away was actually the strongest one, but he was designed to run away if the battle went south. So he did exactly as planned. You didn't even get to talk to him. They had lore and everything. You'll never know.
No.
Just beat them the
Chris.
Fuck up.
Well,
it's okay.
First, I was trying to talk to them, so.
Well, you piss them off. You're just like, about that stolen necklace. You're like, fuck you. We don't got it. Stab him.
I'm just personally interested to see how this all changes the world surrounding everybody within the watch. Hint, hint.
I will say, I did not. There were conditions. If you guys did not recover the necklace for some reason, either it going into the bandit's hands or getting lost. So everything went exactly as planned, except you actually got the necklace back. So
yay.
There will be consequences.
Yeah, consequences.
And also, you could have at any time turned it into the shopkeep, but you didn't. You sent it off to Arnold, and that's exactly where it belongs. So
well,
something
I mean,
might
we
happen.
We discussed it with the shopkeep, so
it's true. You.
I'm back. I'm sorry.
You did the thing. The necklace is in the hands of a knowledgeable person. Something might happen.
Can't wait.
Yeah.
But on that note, it's time to peace out. So
it's like 5.5 hours.
Yeah. The first part took longer than anticipated because I'm just new at all this. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing.
And
I feel like we did pretty good though.
Yeah, that was pretty solid. There's gonna be no more of that like moving around the map role play anymore. It's all going to be theater to the mind like the last half.
Yeah.
So it'll be faster next time. Especially now I know what the fuck I'm doing. But yeah, it's time to go. So say goodbye to stream.
Bye.
Bye, stream.
Bye.
Thanks for hanging out with us.
Bye.
I love you.
You're pretty good.
You're pretty good. How do I shut you people up? Here we go again. Okay, now they can't hear you. You're ruined. But stream can hear me. And it's time to say goodbye to them. So yeah, thanks for hanging out. This is my first time DMing, so everything is just kind of new to me. It's just what it is. But thank you for just chilling. It was a really good time, a really good experience, and it turned out very different from the way I thought it would, to be 100% honest. But yeah, thank you for hanging out. And we should be doing D&D sessions pretty much every Sunday. So hopefully I see you then. I, however, will see you for now. And I hope you have a good week ahead of you. Have a good day. Peace out.